Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this epic tutorial series on Duck UI. That is Swift UI in UIKit. Well, kind of. And today we are going to take our list to the extremes. We are going to add a separate list in the header of our list. So stay tuned. Let's jump right into the code. Okay, let me just build and run this code and show you what we have created. Well, it's kind of ugly, but it has all the features that you can implement here. And what I want to do here is basically add a top view and add a scrollable view. As you can see, this is newsfeed and these are posts. Yeah, it's ugly, but I want to have a scrollable list, and that will be a horizontal list on top here. So as you can see, this header moves forward up with the list. I don't want to do that. I want to have that scrollable list of users displayed all the time. So what I need here is a top view. And as you can see, now we are using our top view. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go ahead and take a look at the previous episodes where I talk about the top view. So let's just scroll all the way up here. And in the view did load setup, you already have this commented out. So let's comment that back in, and I will have this as 100. So let's build and run and see how that looks. So now I'm adding the top view where we will have our list. Okay, this is the top view. And if you see, okay, that is going under, that is okay, that's the header. That's fine by me. We won't be talking about this styling this moment. We are just going to talk about this top view. We are going to add a new list there. Okay, so I just stop this from running. We have our top view. What we want to add here is maybe a label. So let's create our label up here under the views, and let's create our, let's say, users title label. Okay, that is fine, and it will be a UI label. And let's set its font to be, let's say, bold system font of, let's say, 18 maybe, and let's have a text on it with users. Okay, if you recall, this chaining of properties is a part of Duck UI, so go ahead and take a look at the episodes. I just don't know how to say it otherwise. You just need to learn this. This is super awesome. So now we have our user's title. We want to add that to our top view, and I will just create a new function here that will be called setup top view. Okay, so setup top view. Just copy that out and just go ahead all the way down here, maybe under setup views. Let's mark this as setup top view, and let's create a file private, my private function called setup top view. There we go. Let me just see that. And in here, I'm just going to stack, create a vertical stack. So vertical. And yeah, again, vertical stacks, go ahead and find that out. And I will just use filling parent and let's see, layout in our top view. Okay, and let's just add this, I believe it's called users label. Yeah, users title label, that is okay. And yeah, let's see how that looks. It should display it in the center of our top view. Okay, and it is users, that is great. Of course, we might want to add in here some spacer maybe, so we can bump it up. And let's add some insets, insetting by, let's say, let's inset it by, well, let's have that. Okay, so let's build and run again and see how that looks. Okay, there we have 10 users and another 10 for insets. And now we should have, let's see, at least 100. So let's move our, let's bump rather yet our top view's height. Let's say those two insets are 20, again, something 20. So let's have this to 150. So I want to have those cells for the users to be 100 of height and width, of course. So that's why I added in here some more space. Okay, that looks really nice. Now, we want to create the list for our users. So let's create a new group here. So new group, and let's name this users. And let's just create a simple list. So let's just scroll down to our DocUI, the list controller, click on next, and the controller name will be, I believe, let's see, users. That is okay. Users, that will be users view controller, of course, and the cell model will be a a user profile, because I already added profile, if you recall, in the for the header of our main list. So this will be a user profile. Okay, that will be the model name. Okay, let's click on next here and let's create it. Okay, and that is it. Users view controller, it works out of the box. Now it's time to add that to our newsfeed view controller's top view. Okay, in the setup top view. For now, first we need to create our view. So under views, let's just first create our view controller. So let users view controller. Okay, and this needs to be done like this. First, you need to create your view controller, and then you need to create or grab your view from that view controller. So users view controller equals users view controller, and we have something called scroll direction. So we will use our horizontal scroll direction. Okay, and next up, we create our users view, and that is, and I believe we need to have a lazy var here, lazy var, because we are accessing our users view controller. So users view controller view, and bang that out, because we already know that we do have that view. And let's see, set height of 100. Okay, we're setting the height to be 100, and now we can grab this users view and just add it to our stack. Now, how easy was that? Let's just go all the way down here, just add it to our stack. Now, that should be it. Let's see how that works. And I know you're surprised. And that is how simple it is, hopefully, finger crossed. Okay, now here we go. We have some problems because, yeah, you know, this is set to be much higher because it's set to be the third, the width and the height, to be the third of the width of our screen. So the width of the cell and the height of the cell is set to be the third of the width of the screen. So let's fix that real quickly so we can see that all of this really works. So under the user's view controller, let's just navigate all the way down to the delegate flow layout, and let's go to our view frame. So the width and height should be 100. So I'm just adding here 100. And one thing, let's go to the user's cell model, and maybe let's have this blue to be, let's say, green. Okay, so we will have some more. So let's build and run, and there you go. We have everything that we need. Okay, let's add some more cells. Okay, let's go to our item. Of course, these are dummy cells, so keep in mind that you will feed these cells later on in the fetch or something like that. You just fetch the data and then just apply it to this cell. Okay, there we go. Going up, here we have our users. Really, really nice. Okay, now that is basically the most complicated that I can think of, but of course there are much more complicated user interfaces. But that is some really cool stuff that we just did in a few minutes, or a few tens of minutes, or maximum half an hour, and you are already here with all of this functionality already working. So let's tap me. Did tab button with tag 0, in cell with item, user profile with the UID of 1. How awesome is that? So we tap on here. If you tap on the second one, tap me again. It's truncating, but it's okay. Tag 1. How awesome is that? Now, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed lists, and you are going to implement them in your projects. And if you have any questions, just go ahead and comment down below. I'm eager to find out your issues, your questions, and I will answer them as soon as possible. And if you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you did love it, go ahead and subscribe and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.